Very scary combo to face,
and
especially
he's,
early game.
Less greedy than the Sand King as well,
yep.
In terms of being able to initiate without needing anything, really.
Okay, players have selected their heroes. They are in game. They're lock and loaded, and we're ready for what could be the final game of Team Secret at the International 5. Let's find out whether IG have got what it takes as we head back to the commentary team.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. We're live here at Key Arena getting ready for game number 2 of this best of 3 elimination match. No matter who takes the series, Blitz, multiple international champions will go home, be it IG, be it Secret. Both of these teams have been here on the biggest stage and they've done it before, but only one can move forward.
I can't believe that Secret is in this position. They were knocked down to the lower bracket by eHome, a team that is incredibly good, but most thought Secret would run over, and I didn't really see a lot of people give IG much of a chance at all, especially with how they played in the group stage, but I mean, Secret is one game away from elimination at this point, and I definitely didn't see that coming.
Well, they have gone with 2 unconventional picks in this game. The Luna only played twice so far in TI, and she's 2-0. The Zeus, 1-8, only played 9 times the entire tournament, so neither hero very popular in this event. We used to see Luna a lot when the push strats were more in vogue, and of course the Zeus used to be a lot more popular going back, back to 6.83 and even before that. Cloud9 probably the team that ran it the most. But let's get underway here. Kuroki will be the man to move forward, scouting things out for Secret, heading towards the top side of the map. Chuan sits with a Dust, currently in vision of Secret. Artesia is already taking the Lunar Blessing here. Looks like they want to get something going early at the top rune, get some momentum, which, I mean, they have had. They have had momentum in these games, but especially in the last one.
Yeah, it just seemed like they had trouble closing out the game, but this Zeus versus Shadow Fiend matchup is really interesting because against a Shadow Fiend, you typically want to pick a hero that can zone him out of the lane or have potential to solo kill, but Zeus isn't really that hero because he doesn't have the best base damage. Like, when he's apart from the Luna, he only has 45. That's only 3 more than a Shadow Fiend who has one of the lowest
base
damages in the game.
Here comes the charge. The cogs are ready. It's going to block Chuan away. Zytrap from the side comes burning. They're going to work on the clockwork as Luo moves forward, zoning the rest of the team back. Shadow Fiend engaging into the river. Still isn't skilled anything. Who gets the bounty rune? Arteezy grabbing one, the Shadow Fiend the other. Zai on the run now. Iron Shell burning him down slowly as Luo's on the chase. But the first blood is Kuro and the bounty hunter. They're looking for 2. Still diving. Luo can't quite get it done despite the karate chop. At Secret, a slower start here. They do at least get the bounty rune for Arteezy, I should say, but he's off in the safe lane, so this mid lane, IG gonna be happy about how things kick off. A first blood and a bounty rune for the Shadow Fiend. So, well, with that said, Blitz, it's gonna be a tough matchup now for S4.
Yeah, Zeus is a hero that's just gonna trade CS anyways, but you definitely don't wanna see Ferrari get that type of start because now he has the potential to kill you. He's gonna hit the level 3 a lot sooner than you are, and it's going to be harder for S4 to pressure, especially since Ferrari decided to really smartly go for the fully completed Magic Wand first instead of something like that Wraith Band, and now he has the base damage lead against the Zeus. It's going to be so hard for him to deny. So all S4 can really do in this lane now is trade CS, and that's what you do pick Zeus for, so it's not too big of a deal.
Look at this, kind of a greedier play here from IG. They're not actually just running the standard offlane here in the Darkseer. Luo is jungling, and Kuro's moving through the woods. You generally don't see teams try to get greedy in their jungle when they're up against the bounty hunter, and Kuro is going to scout him out. The ping comes, actually dropping rather low here. Luo's at least going to give up experience. If he's not careful, maybe even a hero kill. He's out of mana, and Kuro goes in. The creeps are going to help him out. Kuro looking to make plays here. Luo has the salve. He uses it, almost immediately canceled. Gets some experience and drives him off the jungle already. They were trying to maybe give Chuan a bit bottom. He's actually stacking ancients. Already you can see an initial stack coming out. They're just abandoning the offlane here versus the Luna.
I think they realize the Luna plus the Lina has so much kill potential. If Puppy manages to land the stun, the base damage from Luna is one of the highest in the game with her Lunar Blessing, and so it's a little bit too hard for him to be able to stay there. And with how mid's going, I mean, the Zeus isn't doing... He's got 8 CS, but at the same time, Ferrari's doing such a good job, it's hard for him to keep up.
Yeah, no stacks right now for 430, as those were being farmed by Luo's Darkseer. He will head bottom. He should be able to get level 2 momentarily. Chuan even coming in just to help secure this, and they make it aggressive in the lane versus Luna. Traditionally where she's a bit weak is this stage. If you run at her early and she doesn't have a whole lot of backup, she's got good move speed but no real escape mechanism and is rather squishy. But there is support here currently. The Lina of Puppy will be protected, but top lane, the action's gonna break out. Faith trapped in the cogs of Zai. He's gonna fight this one. He's even taking poison touch. It won't help him. Secret get on the board, making it 1-1, evening the kill score out. Nice rotations from Kuroki, shutting down the Darkseer jungle, forcing him towards bottom, now striking again top. We have seen Bounty Hunter, one of the most successful heroes in this event, especially on the big stage. I know K-Poptosis has talked about it, and the stats are very good for the hero, and we see Kuroki making full use of his early laning prowess here.
I mean, the issue with dual laning against that Clockwork is, especially with Burning having so little mana, it's so hard for them to zone it out, and you saw the Dazzle even skip the Grave and go for the Poison Touch just to be able to harass, but it doesn't really do too much, and Clockwork has one of the better HP pools to work with, 720, and if you don't have that heavy right-clicker, no real reliable nuke, it's going to be so hard to zone him out.
They're going to get on the top lane. Kuroki trying to get aggressive on Burning, has the Manko, but with the creep wave pushing in, Zai's going to sit there and farm it. He's just not going to be allowed to get too much gold or experience right now. And they are slowing down this PL. Meanwhile, free farm for Arteezy bottom, already 21-8. Point ahead in that department, but mid. They make the move onto S4. The charge comes out. The raises are there, and S4, he's not had an easy go of it here in the mid lane on the main stage. And again, gets pressured. Just no backup for the Zeus.
This just isn't a lane that he was going to win in the beginning. Once Ferrari had that kill head start, he had that bounty rune on top of that, and I mean, that just makes it even worse. He knows that Ferrari was invis.
Oh,
he saw the bottle beforehand, but they still weren't able to do anything.
They have dust here on Chuan. This could be bad for Kuro. Dust popped, but he's up the hill. Kuroki gonna retreat. Oh, that's a close call. You get the charge off, you have two level 3 raises coming out. Probably enough to kill the bounty hunter right there. Kuro will dodge a bullet, he baits out a dust, and that leaves the Spirit Breaker, Chuan, with none. Just now getting his boots, a bit under-leveled.
They're gonna swap lanes now, I think. Ferrari can go to the jungle if he wants here, and just give Chuan a little bit of levels, but Chuan just opts to pick up the level 3, and he's gonna charge in this top lane.
They find Luo, but S4 looks for the big body box, can't quite corral him in. He will surge away. Still forcing him out of the jungle again, this puppy. We'll go back to pulling here momentarily, it looks like. And so far, the Shadow Fiend of 430, as you would expect, off to a hot start, and trying to keep up and doing a pretty good job of it so far is Arteezy. The rest of the heroes rather far behind through the early laning stage.
The good news, though, is that Burning is being pressured incredibly hard. He doesn't have the best CS to work with. 16 CS at 4 minutes, or 5 minutes actually, is about 20 behind where you want to be as a safe lane carry.
Just change up from last game, especially. They're looking for Luo bottom. They get the chain stun coming from the Lucent Beam. Arteezy at another. It's not required. And meanwhile, top Kuroki is being pursued, but there's no detection here on Chuan. 430 also stalking him, throws out a wild raise. He's going for the twofer, but Kuro, he dodged the other way. The courier nearly brought down what that was going on. The Soul Ring's there. It's going to make it out. So Kuroki finding a lot of pressure on the map, and it's where Chuan just needs a pack of dust to shut this down.
And this is why Luo decided to go for the jungle first, because he knew that this was going to be a difficult lane to begin with. That combination of just two range heroes, the Lunar Blessing, one or two nukes from either of the heroes is enough to bring him down, and you have to be worried about that at all times as a Darkseer who you've got the surge, but at the same time, if you get stunned locked down, it's hard to be able to survive, and Puppy was on point there. But what I'm a little bit concerned for with Secret is this mid matchup. Ferrari's snowballing incredibly hard. He's already got treads. There's almost no chance that they can kill him right now. They're going to have Sentry Wards pretty much the entire game mid for him, and they have to slow him down this game because he has the potential to just go off.
He's level 7. The max raise is now available. Keep an eye on the Dire Jungle. No stacks here for 430, so he won't be able to accelerate his farm to the extent we've seen it. And a lot of that does come down to the Darkseer. S4, nice D ward near mid, denying 430 the uphill vision that he's craving. No sentries here either. That could give Secret a little room to maneuver. And it's one of the nice things about the Zeus together with the Bounty Hunter Blitz is you can always keep that mid lane dewarded if you place your lightning bolts just right.
Yeah, you nearly almost always have map control. But S4 already forced back. And so, this top lane, they have to kill Zai here because they need to open up the map a little bit more for Burning. The amount of farm that he has just isn't enough to cut it. And Ferrari's far enough ahead that he can sacrifice a little bit of farm to just come up here and try to pressure, but it's going to take a little bit too long, and I mean, Zai's playing so carefully.
They're just going to push already. Buckler coming out for 430. He has a double damage rune, and they think this means just a free tower. Puppy has just rotated in towards mid. He's going to swing towards top, but with no Zai hookshot available just yet, and with Kuroki not having level 6, IG get aggressive before the tracks come into play. They do have Luo currently parked bottom, soaking up experience. Mid lane being pushed a bit by S4. He does have the ult. maybe something they can use together with the stun to go for a quick pickoff. Out comes the nuke from Puffy. Stun onto Burning, it will connect. Shuriken available. He's close to the kill range, but he's going to bottle up, stay alive. Zai still not level 6. The deny is there. Well played by the young Swede. Calm under pressure. And they almost have these heroes in kill range for the Zeus, who is now going to rotate towards top. But at least for now, it seems nobody's going to be quite low enough. Hulk is just a creep or two away. Zai's got it now. Could he go for the Hulk here? There is a doppelganger available. They can combo this. Hulk, rocket, and no Zeus hold even needed. Zai does it alone. Very, very well executed by Secret. Looking for an additional D ward up the hill, S4. Not going to find anything, but does get eyes on Chuan.
Oh, he's getting
blocked. Oh, he's in danger.
The
creeps are working against Chuan, and he's going to have to back his way out. He charges away with the lightning bolt on cooldown. No way to stop that. But it does keep Chuan on the defensive. That was a very early group up from IG. We generally don't see it quite that soon.
I think it was just in response to the catapult coming, and they had the DD rune. You have to open up some space on the map for burning. If you take that tier 1 tower down, it means that he can just go to the jungle, you can farm a little bit more safe, you can pull your own creeps if you want. And it just makes it a little bit more difficult for Zai to push out this aggressively because he doesn't have a tower for heroes to TP to. So it does open up the map a little bit for burning, but Secret with a perfect response, getting burning low. Burning didn't want to use that doppelganger, 25 second cooldown. In that situation, it was probably worth it, but Zai perfectly played there. He throws the rocket first, so he doesn't scare him, but he does enough damage and simultaneously launches the hook at the same time, able to nail that kill. And I mean, Burning is just so underfarmed right now, and this is a game where I feel like Secret just want to run at IG, because Luna is a five-man hero.
And they almost have track. That's the big thing here. Kuroki already hit level 5, which, considering how often he's been off the lane, is pretty good for him. That'll be, it feels like, the big thing they don't currently have, which is going to kick the aggression into overdrive. Secret as they make their move on bottom, Secret are already smoking away from this lane. Are they wrapping around somewhere? Looks like they head towards mid. In fact, yep, they're going to backstab the tower. Nobody from IG waiting, but it could lead to a freebie, as IG are also smoked. And even if they go towards mid, they'll be spotted as their own smoke does wear off. They plop down a lane ward mid, Secret moving past this lane. Just showing S4, not the best pushing here. Both teams probably having a good idea where the opposition is. Burning the one man who's in slight danger of being caught out.
I think Secret actually thought that the Shadow Fiend would be in the jungle if he wasn't mid, because he didn't show himself at bottom, but...
Uh-oh. This would be big for Secret. Burning already having a tough game. He gets lightning bolted and just slain. Absolutely slaughtered. Walked right into Secret's waiting arms. Didn't have a chance. And Secret, despite the early tower going against them, are already leading by 2,000 gold, 2,500 experience. Starting to pull ahead with this one, Blitz. And look at this from IG. They have another double damager in 430. Looking to match S4 in the rune department. What a timing for this, but Chuan will get bashed, and they start to work on the big rock in the pit.
They don't have a medallion, but with this DD rune on the Shadow Fiend, I mean, they should be able to take this down. It's a pretty weak Roshan, only 8,500 HP, not a whole lot of armor. And once they grab this, IG are going to feel so emboldened.
This is the mech. This is the mech as well.
Secret's going to see this coming, but it's way too late as Ferrari is going to pick up the Aegis. Like you said, it's the mech, and I think that means a signal to go for the five-man.
Who do you favor here in the five-man? Both teams have a lot of team fight with the, you know, the analyst. Oh, well, we're gonna see a charge. No, just kidding. Chuan just making sure it still works, and in fact, he finds the charge is not broken. But yeah, with the Zeus final pick, it did amp up Secret's team fight potential quite a bit. Going into that, they mentioned, and I think you would agree, it was more gank-centric, but this shores up their team fight potential early on. So, with the Aegis and the mech, do you see IG just far stronger in those clashes, or do you think Secret can take them?
I don't think it's far stronger, but Secret, they just have to outmaneuver them. The problem is, when you have a hero like Clockwork, you go in, you're pretty much hard committed to that. Mm-hmm. Whereas IG, they've got a lot of different ways to re-engage, get out of there. You've got the Doppelganger from the Phantom Lancer, you've got Surge from Darkseer, the Charge from Chuan. The Shadow Fiend is a little bit of a hard commitment, but...
Oh, Kuro, he went for just a split-second track, but he got scouted out, and there's dust on Chuan. Those reactions, almost instantaneous. He gets two tracks out, but it cost him his life. He was uphill, and he showed himself for, like, just a quarter of a second, really. Chuan was just expecting it, it seems.
The strength of that combination, the Darkseer plus the Spearbreaker, is so good. I think IG always picks some sort of combo with that. They make sure that there's some way to abuse the Ion Shell, even in the later phases of the game, so it's not wasted. It is a lot of additional damage, especially against supports in the mid and late game. I think they feel really comfortable drafting that hero for Luo every time, but the mech is now completed on the Shadow Fiend. They're gathered up as three. Burning's just showing himself at bottom. I think he just doesn't want to make sure that Arteezy gets free farm. And at the same time, this is a pretty safe lane for him to be in because Secret's not really going to go to that side of the map anymore.
It's also tough for them to gank a Phantom Lancer here. You've got the hook, but you can always just Doppelganger away. If they hit the combo right, they have a ton of burst, but it does rely on getting that initiation off. And he's at the tower, so not an easy takedown. We're going to see Arteezy go into drum splits, and normally as a carry, Arteezy known more for the farming-oriented builds. Sometimes we'll see like an early mech on Shadow Fiend, but he still focuses a lot on hitting creeps and getting ahead early. But so far, his Luna build, very, very teamfight-centric, very five-man-centric, and they are starting to congregate here. They find the hook. It's a deep one onto Faith. He's completely trapped out. Can even get off a grave. No chance in hell as the Thunder God's Wrath will finish him off. Now 430 rotating in. He tries to go with the mech to salvage that, but a bit too late. Arteezy, Lucent Beam number one coming in, and it looks like Secret want to take this head on. Out goes the Lance. The Zeus four step already online to try and counter this IG aggression.
I think the main reason why the Luna decided to go for the drums, by the way, is because there's no natural mech carrier on the side of Secret. You ideally want your Bounty Hunter to have some insane start, and he can get Guardian Greaves at some point, but at this phase of the game, 14 minutes in, you're not going to have a mech on your carry to help out your carry, so you need a little bit more HP. Going for a BKB this early on pretty much means you lose the game as past the 20-minute mark once you've used two or three charges, and so going for the drums is smarter.
He's in a good position here. He's got the Eclipse at the ready. Is he going to go with it first? Lucent Beam to start, track to follow. Faith blown up again. Secret finding the pickoffs here. Can they turn this into a tower push? That's the question right now. Still a couple of IG heroes in the neighborhood, but the hookshot is going to cool down in 2 seconds. Even so, as Zai bottles up a Haster, and they will back off, and IG get their own four step. Luo rushed this. He did not go for the mech, because that was what 430 grabbed first. This will be their attempted solution to the hookshot. But at least for now, it feels like you don't need to trap a hero in Cogs. Just that initial hook in a Laguna Blade Zeus ult is enough to kill about anyone. Puppy TPing out, and again, he'll dodge the charge. I think they actually might have seen him moving towards that bottom lane from the mid ward, and they dodge yet another gank. Haven't seen too much aggression out of Tron aside from that one Bounty Hunter kill.
I mean, he's trying time and time again, but
Secret are just ready for it.
Yeah, exactly. And at the same time, this Lina has a surprising amount of farm. She's 1-0-4, 44 CS to boot. With just a little bit more tower gold, she'll have a full Yulz. And this is going to pay off huge because nobody from IG is nowhere near a BKB right now. Like, Burning is going to suffer from this. And it's going to slow down things like the Darkseer Surge. It's going to be really effective against Chuan, for example. And this is on the support Lina.
They are going to charge top. Chuan, a long gallop across the map, may get scouted out here. Now the fight breaking out. 430, the first man in, will lose the Aegis, but he will have a second life. Eclipse is prepping. It's hitting creeps for now. It will bring down Luo. Fair 430 also dead. He didn't mech. He didn't get it off. And now Secret Chain forward, a hook again. Combination after combination. Just slaughtering IG under the tower. They thought with two lives, they would really be able to hold that with the Shadow Fiend, but too much burst from Secret. IG getting overconfident, overzealous, and heavily punished. The graph spikes dramatically upwards. They lead with a hero that loves to stay ahead, the Bounty Hunter, and looks to extend that lead. They now get a Midas on Zai's Clockwork, further looking to cement the advantage here heading towards the mid game. And they are also out farming them. You look at creep scores, and it's not even close for 430. Arteezy farmed amazingly well on the Shadow Fiend, but he's 43 CS down on the Luna, only 16 minutes in.
I mean, they've just put so much pressure on Burning at all times. He hasn't actually had time to collect himself and find space for the farm. They got that kill on him at top. He was constantly pressured by the mid pushes. And I mean, Arteezy didn't really just let him relent at that bottom lane. And if you take a look at his items right now, he's actually lower in net worth than the Bounty Hunter who's been roaming this entire game. That's a terrible sign of your Secret.
And meanwhile,
or IG.
Meanwhile, Puppy's atop him. He's the fourth position here on Secret, but you wouldn't know it. Already a Yule's complete with three towers taken down. The supports are getting their farm too, and he's close to being able to solo kill even Burning, who's gone for the very defensive early cheap item build. Let alone the supports who are just mincemeat for his Lina. Everybody in Secret feeling like they will be a factor this game, and right now a desperately starved Dazzle, a somewhat underfarmed Chuan, though not horribly so. And then the cores, as you mentioned, quite far behind.
There's just so many things that that Yule Scepter early game can't stop, Chuan being the chief one among them. And before Ferrari gets his BKB, it's going to be incredibly useful. And I think with that, Secret are just going to continue to push their advantage. They still don't have a mech on any of their heroes, unless that's one flying in on the courier. Kuro's pretty close to it, but they're just struggling a little bit too hard to piece anything together as IG. They don't have that overwhelming teamfight presence like they did last game. There's not a ton of reliable disables. The Spiritbreaker's okay for it, but there's a lot of different counters to him this game.
There's the Lightning Bolt, we've seen that. There's the potential Lina stun, the Yule's the easy one. Lucent Beam really good at canceling charge. They have a lot of counters to his initiation, and that's where you'd like someone else to go in first. But, I mean, who's really going to do it? No Blink Dagger on Luo, just a 4-staff, and only a level 1 back anyway. So it does feel like it falls to the outgunned Spiritbreaker to get the job done against all odds right now. They are starting to find a little more space here for Birdie, though. He pushes in the top lane, he has completed the drums, but at the same time, the pressure mounts from Secret bottom. They've got the aggressive wards up, one top, one towards the bottom lane on the hill. Very impressive map control with a Kuroki Bounty Hunter constantly moving about. Another tower down. It's all but one already claimed for Secret. Barely 18 minutes into the game. And now they hunt for more. They are going to find Faith. Lightning Bolt comes out. He immediately gets Yule stunned and done. Secret making it look easy as they hunt for more. Hook. Oh, 430. Give him a half second longer and he's done for there. Barely able to escape from Zai's incoming hookshot. Still, the jungle once again taken over, and IG just having to play keep away, burning back towards bottom. But it's slow going compared to the anti-mage from last game, Blitz. He just doesn't have the farm to quickly shove these lanes in.
Part of the reason we were so confident that IG could make that comeback is because a hero like anti-mage flash farms so quickly. When you're behind, you can be really daring, you can push in lanes really far, and at the same time, he had reliable disables backing him up at all times.
Kuro sees the courier, and he's going for it. It's gonna take two, one. Oh no, gets it with one. They will deward, but the damage is done. Nothing actually on the courier. Still, more gold into an already loaded secret lineup. They're closing in on like a 750, 800 gold per minute advantage being gained here. Not quite the total stomp 1,000, but it's damn close at this point.
I mean, 12K net worth lead already. Arteezy's got a full SNY, max stats already. He doesn't have to go for that early BKB, and I can't stress how crucial that is. If he goes for the early BKB and IG burn off a few charges, and when it gets to the later phase of the game, it becomes much less effective for the Luna. But the fact that he just decided to go for the stats build means that he's going to be able to fight in this early game, but at the same time in the late game, he's going to be just as effective.
Keeping an aggressive posture throughout the map here. He will walk into 430. He could kill him with an Eclipse, I believe. Zusol coming out. 430 in quite a bit of danger. Lucent Beam can stop the TP. He's trying to fog him. And Arteezy doesn't want to risk blowing the Eclipse, but he may walk right back into 430, who plays a bit of peekaboo, ends up backing off. Again, gotta look at the wards here for Secret. They just have so much vision and map control. They're even gonna scout out Chuan charging towards bottom, where Burning is hoping for an opening, but already S4 is TP'd out, so that opportunity doesn't amount to anything. Still, Secret just one step ahead of IG everywhere they go, and now they zero in on Faith. Ping comes out from Kuro, continue to track him, actually tracks him now, and we'll end up backing off.
And that's a 20-minute Bloodstone 4-staff from S4. Incredibly fast considering the start he had. He's second in net worth right now. And the Shadow Fiend starts to fall far behind his, even with a BKB.
Well, IG, it seems they were doing a little stacking, but for the wrong team here. Arteezy's going to clean up. Meanwhile, top lane, Kuroki prevents 430 from moving back while Arteezy is stealing the Dire Ancients. He gets a double stack, 1,800 more gold. If he wants that point booster, he could buy it now, but the chase continues on 430. He's got to get all the way back. Puppy's here. Can they counter this with a charge? Their stun already used. They get the combo up. Is it enough? Laguna, not quite sufficient. They go in with more auto attack damage from Kuro. Another stun coming out. Not enough. Kuro survives barely, and they turn it in the end, bringing down the Bounty Hunter, saving the Shadow Fiend, but cost them a Darkseer. Another Lucent Beam. He will make it back. But IG, it takes the whole five-man squad, and all it costs them is a Bounty Hunter. It's an even net worth exchange there in the end. Secret still bottling IG up, and now do they even look towards mid? They didn't use Eclipse, they still have Zeus ult, and the wall is down.
I think this game, especially after how last game went, Arteezy's a little bit more content to just farm instead of going for these solo kill plays. Obviously, he's not playing that Blink Dagger Yule Shadow Fiend, and so he's just going to rely on the amount of farm that he's getting. And he has to know, even with that Ancient stack, he's well ahead of Burning right now. Just judging their farm, Burning's about to get a Diffusal Blade, but that's not nearly enough for him to be in fighting condition because, I mean, Secret have a ton of AoE. You've got the Zeus, who can just Arc Lightning spam. He's already level 13. He's got pretty much infinite mana with that. He can spam the Lightning Bolt, and that'll instantly force Phantom Lancer back. So he needs probably another item or two, maybe something like a Heart or a Scotty to even approach fighting distance, but Arteezy, he's actually got so much farm right now, 2,500 gold, this Pierce stats build like we talked about, and with this Aegis too, this should mean another tier 2 tower and maybe even high ground.
Let's see if Secret will go for it. For now, it's the Roche. Arteezy, an unfortunate bash. He does have Frost armor from the Ogre Frost Mage, so up to 31 armor and the attack speed slow. Roshan just can't take the pummeling that Secret are administering.
That's a full Aghanim Scepter completed on Puppy, by the way.
Uh-oh.
That's a 23-minute Aghanim's Yule Scepter.
So I'm looking at Dazzle here. Faith has 739 health. He's almost a one-shot at 23 minutes as a support Lina. Free Aegis. It's not even an attempted contest. Hell, you look at Burning, 1290 HP. This Laguna Blade's half his health.
This is pretty much...
And that's your carry. That's your one position.
This is like a slightly under-farmed core Lina.
Slightly.
Like mid,
he's the third most farmed. He's almost up there with S4 Zeus, and he didn't even go for something greedy like a Midas.
That's what I mean.
They found Luo. So he's got the 4-step. No chance to even use it during the hookshot stun. They burst him down. That's without a Zeus ult. That's without the Laguna Blade even. IG, no chance for split push. Secret, they took a long time to try to end the last game, perhaps too long, as they fell short, and they waste no time in breaching base now. They are just so damn far ahead. IG, if they can somehow hold, that they just have to be one of the scariest high ground teams in this event, but it's gonna be the absolute hardest hold of their tournament lives right now. As Burning gets quickly nuked down, he's got to worry about this Laguna Blade from Puppy. Sitting far back, tower about to drop. Nobody wants to go in. Nobody wants to get close to Secret, and that means it's the rats that take a pounding as Burning jumps his way back. The Zeus ult finds him. Another freebie. Secret just making it look easy here. IG, one lane of Rex down, 24 minutes in. They've been on the break. They've lost three games in a row on the main stage here in Key Arena Blitz, but it hasn't fazed them, not even a bit. They're going in. They want the Shadow Fiend back. Can they turn it? Charge from Chuan. Good combo. They get Puppy, but now the Requiem for 430 trying to kill up Arteezy. He can't do it. He's still got Aegis. He's going to go for Faith instead. They only lose the lead, and the racks are down. Still the track gold going Secret's way. Everybody on IG backing off, and what do they even have left at this point? There's a freaking Chivas on Zai. We're 25 minutes in. They're getting late game items. This looks like it's 40 minutes in. Butterfly could pretty much be finished for Arteezy. He's already got the evasion available, but he doesn't even care to wait for it. It's 4:30 next. Tracked up, back to the well with Yesay Secret. We want two lanes of Rax. We're not giving you a chance to turtle. No chance for a comeback is the goal. Just end it now, end it quickly. And boy, this base is crumbling.
They have to do something. They can't really give up the second set of Rax, but IG start to realize this is just not enough for them to hold. The illusions from Burning almost instantly go down. The Shadow Fiend is being nuked to all hell. This bottom Rax is definitely gonna fall.
It's Arteezy in front, and GG, IG, they know they're toast. It's a complete turn of the events, and we go to our second game three of the main event here. Oh boy, Blitz. Day number three turned out to be much closer down the stretch.
Yeah, and Secret this time around, they waste no time taking care of business. They say to themselves, we're not worried about the split push anymore. We're just going to end this game on our terms.